golf, it could be not. But when you really write down things that you're deeply proud of with yourself, you realize that your accomplishments, they don't really need, like, that's why I put don't need a ribbon. Because it's all yours. Nobody can take those away from you. So it's super important that occasionally you write down the things that you're really proud of for yourself, because I don't think we tell ourselves that enough. You know, like, everything could be, like, 3 months ago, my life changed significantly. Even for the better, most of it. But I got shaken up, my world shook up. And you know, to me, when things get shaken up, it's for a reason, because it's to make room for other things to come in. But because I have pride on the inside, during that shakeup, nobody's comfortable when your world moves around, but during that shakeup, I was able to be proud of myself. And it wasn't about my behaviors while I was in the shakeup, it was about everything that I have, everything that I've accomplished, the things that, the people that I love, and the people that love me, and all those little things, and work, and maybe some accomplishments recently. But everything that I have that list of what I'm proud of. And you know what? It makes me proud of me. So I don't need to I don't need anybody to say, "Atta girl." I'm a walking billboard for myself when I walk around. And I know I don't mean to have that sound like, oh, I'm all that. This is deep inside, you know, and it takes a while to learn how to do this. But you have the validation right there. So you don't need a ribbon. And if you are proud inside, you're going to play better, you're going to be better, you're going to be a better friend, you're going to be a better teammate, you're going to get every one of your goals. They're going to seem very real now. Okay? And when you're proud, you can be grateful. And I think that is one of the most powerful tools that we have. I mean, when we can be truly grateful. And this might be the first time, besides, you know, your mom talking to you or somebody saying, "Oh, you should be thankful." But thankful is different than grateful. Thankful is thank you for what you did for me. Or thank you, self, for doing that, which we don't really say or feel. But gratefulness is deep. And when you have gratefulness because you're proud, you're inner proud. Not your, "I'm proud." But your inner proud. When you have that inner proud, you're able to be grateful. And when you walk being grateful, everything else around you, you'll see it change. You're going to see all of it change. And it's going to change with your best interest in mind. And everything that you want to happen is going to start to happen. Anywhere you want to go is going to happen. It's a power. It's a superpower. And we're so lucky to be able to have it. Right? I mean, we can have a lot of superpowers, but that's the one.
Some of them have seen that recently. They read the book, "You Are a Badass."
Oh!
And that's...
I haven't read that.
It's great.
Is it?
Yeah. What you just said, that's the superpower.
It is a superpower. And you know, in relation to golf, I'm going to, you know, throw this out there, because, you know, we're here, you know, also about your game. But when you're playing, or I'll just talk about the tour, if you were asking any of the best players in the world, when did they...
put your pants on any differently than Anika Sorensen or Chrissy Kerr or Tiger Woods every single day. I don't care who you are. Right? But when we go out there, can we get the score on the scorecard? Can we have endurance? Can we usually, can we do all these things? So it's funny that the, when asked that question, the majority of them would just say, I was just grateful. Doesn't mean they were simple-minded and just not frolicking through the course. They were focused, but they were grateful. They don't harbor a lot of this anger and, you know, all the stuff we go through on the course with given our variables. So if you took one thing from today, I know there's a lot today, but that's what we're here for. We're just going to get stimulated and, you know, have our mind kind of go in the right direction. So I hope we see how all this works. I hope I was able to tie all that in for you. So we go back to the middle. We're just going to end on that. We're going to go back to the middle. That belief does not need proof of existence. Does that sound a little different now that we've talked? So we're not going to wait for outcomes. We're going to have clear intentions of what you want to do. You're going to hold yourself accountable somehow. And it's going to enable you not to play on the course or in life with hesitation, confusion, frustration, fear, and all the things that pull us down. Because we're gaining confidence, we're starting to really think about our duty and embracing our position. We're doing consciously, we're going to start to really do for our team. And we're going to have pride on the inside.
You guys are the best. You guys want to go hit balls? You have time?
Oh, yeah.
I got this.
A
bunch of ladies coming up.
One question for you guys. You guys, thank you, Megan, first of all.
Sure.
The part about the meltdowns, you know, and that really touched for me, you know, when larger failures happen.
Do you have meltdowns?